All right, we're going to look at something called rationalizing the denominators. A lot of times you'll be asked not to leave radical terms in the denominator. So let's see how we can do that. So for any real numbers, if you have a number a plus b squared root c, then a minus b squared root c is called its conjugate. So same everything except the plus is changed to a minus. These two are conjugates of each other. Look what happens when you multiply the two conjugates. If you do term by term multiplication, a times a is a squared. This will be a times negative b squared root c, which will be negative ab squared root c. This will be positive ab squared root c, which will cancel out with the previous term. And positive and negative make it negative. B times b is b squared. Square root c times square root c is c. So conjugates multiply each other and the radical sign disappears. For any complex number, then remember, I is square root of negative 1. So a plus bi and a minus bi are conjugates of each other. And again, if you multiply, do you remember I squared is negative 1? So you're going to end up with a times a is a squared, a times negative bi, negative abi, plus positive abi cancel out. Positive bi and negative bi will be negative b squared I squared. I squared is negative 1, which will make it positive. So a squared plus b squared. All right. Multiplying the conjugates then will give you 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times 3 plus 6i minus 6i will give you 0i. Negative 3i times positive 3i will give you negative 3i squared. I squared is negative 1, so that'll make it a positive 9. And 4 and 9 will give you 13. Now, look over here. We have square root of 1 half, which is the same as square root 1 over square root 2. They're asking us not to leave any radical terms in the denominator. So square root 2, if I multiply top and bottom by square root 2, look what happens. I'll end up with square root 2 over square root 4, which is the same as square root 2 over 2. So this allowed me to get rid of square root from the denominator. So if it's a single square root, or cube root, or nth root, you just need to have enough of these under the square root so that when you multiply like that, then you get something that's a perfect root so that you can get rid of that root in the solution when you simplify. All right, try that. So simplify first. Oh, look, we can actually reduce the x's. Now, to get rid of the square root from the denominator, multiply numerator denominator by the square root 3x, and we'll get that. Simplify. And now look, this 3 and this 3 will reduce, and you're left with square root 3x over 2x. The trick is how to multiply and get rid of the square roots. So whatever is inside the square root, you need another one of those in order for the root to disappear. Okay, now if you have cube roots, it's a little bit different, right? Because you need 3 of exponent of 3 so that 3/3 will like become 1. So if you look over here, then we have 1, 3. That's 3 to the power 1, but we need 3 to the power 3rd to get rid of the root. So you're going to have to multiply top and bottom by what? Cube root 3 squared. Why? 3 squared because I only have 1, 3. And you have 2y, so you just need one more y. And also here, cube root of 2 will have to stay inside. X to the 4 is 4/3, or 1 and 1/3. So x to the 1 on the outside, and 1 power on the inside. Multiply it out. So 9 times 2, 18xy. And on the bottom, you're going to have cube root of 3 to the 3rd, y to the 3rd, which will give you 3y. Now here, to get rid of a root, the only thing that will get rid of a root when it's something plus something is to multiply top and bottom by the conjugate. So multiply top and bottom by 2 minus root 3. And so now use the distributive property of multiplication over addition or multiplication over subtraction. and then combine like terms. So 1 times 1 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4. 1 times negative square root 3 is negative square root 3, 2 times negative square root 3 is negative 2 square root 3. 3 square root 2 times 2 is 6 square root 2. 3 square root 2 times negative square root 3 will be 3 square root 6. And the bottom, square root 3 times 2 is 2 square root 3. Square root 3 times square root 3, so that'll be square root of 9. All right, so let's simplify here. So add like terms now. So let's see. So numerator, there's nothing like terms. Negative 2 square root 3 plus 2 square root 3 will cancel each other out. Negative square root 3 times square root 3 is 3. And 4 minus 3 will be 1. So denominator of 1 just means you have a numerator then, right? All right, try that. It's just like the problems you did before, except if the radical is reduced, then reduce it. So write everything in factored form so you can see if anything reduces. So 2 to the third is and square root, so that's 3 halves, 1 and a half. So 3y, this 2 will be out here, 1 left inside. 3 thirds, so that's x to the 1 and x to the 1 inside, y will remain inside. Remember, if you're having trouble, this just rewrite it as 3 halves, which is 1 and a half. X is 2 to the 1, and the half power means square root, and so on. So now you should be proficient in simplifying these. So go ahead and simplify, and now add like terms, right? So let's simplify first. 6xy square root 2xy plus 5xy square root 2xy. So those two together will give you 11xy square root 2xy minus another xy square root 2xy, so that'll make it 10xy square root 2xy. X cube root 3y plus 2x cube root 3y. So that will give you 1x cube root 3y. Try these on your own.